Look, if you had one shot, one opportunity to seize everything you ever wanted.
Lose Yourself is one of the greatest hip-hop songs ever written. It was really apropos for the moment.
Movie music does not have to be soaring love ballads. Lose Yourself is definitely an example of a movie song that that makes a movie much more hip and much more popular in today's culture.
I think what Eminem was trying to say in the song is, regardless of what your passion is, that everyone goes through obstacles in trying to achieve their goals, but if you continue to do what you love, you'll succeed.
Dream is here beside me.
Long ago and far away. Oh my goodness. Bless me. It's such a romantic song. Great moment in the movies.
That all I longed for long ago was you.
Taken seriously, you need serious hair.
Let the River Run was very, very well cast, if you will, as a piece of music, because that was all about women in the workplace and their position in society.
Seems like old times from Annie Hall. I remember when I heard Diane Keaton sing, I thought, this lady has the most gorgeous voice I've ever heard.
Old times, having you to walk with, and it's still a thrill just to have.
Come, let's mix, where Rockefellers walk with sticks or umbrellas in their mitts, putting on the Ritz.
Come, let's mix, where Rockefellers walk with sticks or umbrellas in their mitts.
Putting on the Ritz. And that's when the monster really, the creature really thinks he's making it in show business. And the two of them do this wonderful dance, which has some original Fred Astaire choreography in it.
That image of Fred Astaire with the cane it's one of the American treasures.
Doe, a deer, a female deer, Ray, a drop of golden sun. Me, a name I call myself, far, a long, long way to run.
Do Re Mi from The Sound of Music is an amazingly clever song.
La, a note to follow, so.
Not only does it teach you the basics of music, but it also teaches you the actual scale.
Do Re Mi Fa Sol La Ti Do, so do.
It's a beautiful song in French too. Mi c'est la moitié d'un tout, fa c'est facile à chanter.
So I need a pulling thread. La, I know to follow so. Tea, I drink with jam and bread. That would bring us back to.
East is east and west is west, and the wrong one I have chose. Let's go where you'll keep on wearing those frills and flowers and buttons and bows, rings and things and buttons and bows.
Everybody loves Bob Hope. I know his background was vaudeville, then New York, and then he came to the movies, and he did great songs, buttons and bows.
Give me eastern trimming where women are women in high silk hose and peekaboo clothes and French perfume that rocks the room, and you're all mine.
Now I had the time of my life. No, I never felt like this before. Yes, I swear it's a truth, and I owe it all to you.
I've had the time of my life. When we record the song, we thought it was a good song. But once you see it in the movie with all the emotion, and it just makes the song entirely different.
Singing with Bill Medley, who has been singing in duet for many, many years, it's like dancing with Fred Astaire.
Because of the style of Moulin Rouge, we needed one original composition that would be the song that Christian and Satine created together.
I will love you.
I will love you.
I thought that fundamentally this was a song that people could play at their weddings, because wedding songs are the ultimate love ballad.
Put the Blame on Mame was the sexiest thing that ever lit up the screen with heat, female heat.
They once had a shooting up in the Klondike when they got Dan McGrew. Folks were putting the blame on the lady known as Lou. That's the story that went around. But he's the real lowdown.
Some say love, it is a river.
When they came to me with this picture about Janis Joplin, I said, I can't do a picture based on Janis. I don't think anyone will ever capture what she was. I really don't.
It's the dream.
Once I had made that adjustment in my head that this is not Janis, this is an amalgam of all I have lived through and all I have seen, then I was free.
It's the one who won't be taken, who can.
The song talks in metaphor about the way the character felt about herself, the fact that she felt that she would never. She would never be loved for herself.
That never learns to live. away.
And the river runs,
making dreams come true.
Trying hard to look like Gary Cooper.
And you're all mine in buttons and bows.
I am the time of my life.
Come what may.
Mame did a dance called the Hitchy Coo.
Becomes the rose.
A singing frog. Dancing munchkins and Nazi stormtroopers as AFI continues.
Vegas Fridays this fall on CBS.
Then this is a day of independence for all the munchkins and their descendants. If any, yes, let the joyous news be spread. The wicked old witch at last is dead.
Ding dong, the witch is dead. Witch, a witch, a wicked witch. Ding dong, the wicked witch is dead.
If you really don't realize what they're saying, it's a very fun and sweet and lovely song, and then all of a sudden you realize what they're talking about.
I can't put bars on my insides. My love is something I can't hide. It still hurts when I recall the times I've tried, but I'm easy.
I'm easy. It's kind of a straight-ahead, unrequited love song. And there are several women in the club with whom my character in the film had liaisons. And each of them thinks that the song is being sung just to her.
Because I'm easy.
That sort of ironic setting was a perfect counterpoint to a song that, by its own right, was a very sincere expression of love.
Don't do me favors, let me watch you from a distance. 'Cause when you're near, I find it hard to keep my head.
And towards the end of the scene, one of them realizes that it is actually being performed for her.
It's enough to change my mind, make me leave my cautious words and ways behind.
This is wine, women, and song, and women.
Springtime for Hitler. A gay romp with Adolf and Eva at Berchtesgaden.
Wow. Wow. It's practically a love letter to Hitler.
This won't run a week.
A week? Are you kidding? This play has got to close on page 4.
All of Mel's movies are really very theatrical. There's always an audience and there's always a stage. Mel's talent as a lyricist and a songwriter and a musician is unique and funny and original.
Well, talk about bad taste.
Once in your someone who turns your heart around, and next thing you know, closing down the town.
Arthur's theme has quite a quite a history to it.
Peter Allen had written a song with Carol years ago. They had the line, "When you get caught between the moon and New York City."
Peter had come up with that particular line because he was stuck in a holding pattern flying into JFK.
In Peter's words, he said there was a very cute steward. And I turned to the steward and he says, "Stu," I says, "look at this. Here we are, caught between the moon and New York City. What are we going to do?"
If you get caught between the moon and New York City, just best that you can do is fall in love.
Working 9 to 5, what a way to make a living. Getting by, it's all taking and no giving.
When Don Dolly wrote 9 to 5, she really nailed it. It tells the story of the movie, and it also is one of those great country story songs.
A message buried in it that said, you know, we're not going to take it. We're mad as hell and we're not going to take it anymore. It was a song that absolutely captured its time.
Same boat with a lot of your friends, waiting for the day your ship will come in and the tide's going to turn and it's all going to roll your way.
I want you, Laura. I want you.
The shadow of your smile.
Sometimes you remember the smell of the fragrance of the perfume. When love affairs end, you know, you think about the look in their eye, you think about the sound of their voice. But for me, it's that smile.
I will be remembering the shadow of your smile.
Have yourself a your heart.
Not many people realize that Judy wrote a part of that song, part of the lyrics for Have Yourself a Merry Little Christmas. Originally, the lyrics were written very dark, and she said, you know, I can't sing this to little Margaret O'Brien.
So have yourself.
Where We Belong, it's just, I remember sitting there and not really liking the movie. And then that song started. And I loved the movie.
It has that ba-da-da-da-da-da. It's this, the music matching the lyric. We're being lifted up.
Someday we'll find it, the rainbow connection, the lovers, the dreamers, and me.
Well, I sung the Rainbow Connection back in the first Muppet movie, and it was a song that was really popular way out in the swamp, you know.
Have you been half asleep, and have you heard voices? I've heard them calling my name.
You know, Rainbow Connection is really a song about following your own dreams and being true to yourself, and whether you're a realist or an idealist, that sort of fits the bill.
Someday you'll find it, the Rainbow Connection, the lovers, the dreamers, and...
Isn't it romantic? Da-da-da-da-da. A very catchy strain. Isn't it romantic? Da-da-da-da-da. Oh, I forgot my cane.
Isn't it romantic? It's a leitmotif in this whole sequence in the film where you see a guy in a shop who's humming it.
Da, 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 da.
And then a guy's walking by the shop and he picks it up and starts singing it.
At last I've got a pair.
So it's just heard continuously, but it's heard in different forms as it's carried from one location to another.
We've talked the whole night through.
Good morning.
Good morning to you.
Good morning, good morning is such a fun number. And when we did it, it was the most exhausting number. Well, of course, with Gene, you never got it right. I mean, he was Mr. 40 Takers. And of course, I think he printed the first take after 40 takes.
Nice. Okay, good morning.
Good morning.
Rainbow shining.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Bonjour.
worked so hard, we rehearsed so long, and it was the number in which we went over the couch, and all three of us had to hit it at the right time. I don't think I'll ever forget it.
I'm a Yankee Doodle Dandy, Yankee Doodle do or die. A real live nephew of my Uncle Sam, born on the 4th of July.
What's wonderful about Yankee Doodle Dandy is that Cagney was, he just took that number and just made it his own. I mean, he really did. When you think of that song, it's him.
James Cagney did this eccentric dance in it, you know, and did Yankee Doodle Dandy. It's just unforgettable to me.
I'm easy.
Don't be stupid, be a smarty. Come and join the Nazi party.
Mississippi, if we was
in
Mississippi.
Yankee Doodle came to London just to ride the ponies. I am that Yankee Doodle.
Coming up, songs from Bruce Springsteen, Whitney Houston, and our host John Travolta as AFI's 100 Years, 100 Songs continues.
In the song Summer Nights, they're both telling the story to their friends about this person that they met over the summertime. And the girl, she's so sweet, and she's probably telling the whole entire truth. And the guy, he's a little more tough guy, macho, and he's elaborating on the story just a little bit.
He got friendly, holding my hand. Well, she got friendly, down in the sand. He was sweet, just turned 18.
Well, she was good, you know what I mean.
Summer Nights is a tremendous example of what you can do with musical cinematic language. The fact that you're telling two stories at once, but they're unified by the music itself.
Tell me more, how much dough did he spend?
Tell me more,
could she get me a friend?
On the good ship, lollipop, it's a sweet trip to a candy shop where bonbons play.
When you talk about archetypal songs, or songs that seep into the consciousness of every kid, On the Good Ship Lollipop has got to be one of those songs.
See the sugar bowl, do the Tootsie Roll with the big bad devil's food cake.
All I wanted for Christmas was a doll, a Shirley Temple doll. That's how important she was. She was a durable, talented child.
On the good ship, lollipop, it's a night trip. Into bed you hop and dream away. On the good ship, lollipop.
I was bruised and battered, I couldn't tell what I felt. I was unrecognizable to myself. So reflection in a window and didn't know my own face. Oh brother, gonna leave me wasting away the streets of Philadelphia.
Bruce Springsteen composed the song Streets of Philadelphia for the movie Philadelphia. It's a case of the music and the lyric so perfectly underpinning the emotional backbone of that film. He's such a great songwriter.
Excuse me.
Thank you.
The song had a great mood and works in the movie in some way that you probably wouldn't have imagined if you just heard the song beforehand.
And my clothes don't fit me no more. I'm 1,000 miles just to slip this ski.
Nobody does it better. Makes me feel sad for the rest.
At the time, Cubby Broccoli was one of the few people that did his opening credits over a song. So I thought the key was to capture the essence of James Bond, and I think that we did that.
What I thought was so wonderful was not only did Carolyn come up with this great opening line, nobody does it better, but that she was able to actually use the title, you know, The Spy That Loves Me, in the song.
Nobody does it half as good as you. Baby, 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 you're the best.
Through early morning fog I see visions of the things to be, the pains that are withheld for me. I realize and I can see that suicide is painless.
I'll never forget the first time I saw Robert Altman's film MASH. And in the middle of that film, there's this incredible comic sequence where John Shuck, as the dentist Painless, is faced with a life of impotence.
The game of life is hard to play.
And it's driven him to the brink of suicide. When Michael Altman wrote those lyrics, he was a kid. He was, you know, a very young guy. How cool is that?
So this is all I have to say. Suicide is painless. It brings on many changes, and I can take or leave.
I'll always remember you just like this.
Wait.
And I will always love you.
Whitney Houston happens to be my cousin, my first cousin. And I was never prouder of her. You know, here's my little baby becoming a huge movie star.
Bittersweet memories. That is all I'm taking with me. So goodbye. Don't cry.
If you had to look for an epitome of virtuoso, soulful singing, that's one of the great performances ever.
And I will always love you. I will always love you.
Raindrops on roses and whiskers on kittens, bright copper kettles and warm woolen mittens, brown paper packages tied up with strings. These are a few of my favorite things.
I think personally my favorite things is the song I love to sing the most. The lyrics were so great and it was so evocative. Everything one sang, one could see the picture of brown paper packages and raindrops on roses and things like that.
Girls in white dresses with blue satin sashes, snowflakes that stay on my nose and eyelashes, silver white winters that melt into spring. These are a few of my favorite things.
Thanks for the memory of China's funny walls, transatlantic calls,
That weekend at Niagara when we hardly saw the fall.
Thanks for the Memory is a song that Bob Hope always credited with putting him on the map. He said if he hadn't had that song and that scene in that film, he would have gone nowhere in Hollywood.
Strictly Entrenew, darling, how are you?
And how are all those little dreams that never did come true?
Awfully glad I met you.
Cheerio, toodaloo.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Tale as old as time, true as it can be. Barely even friends, then somebody bends unexpectedly.
That's a wonderful moment in the movie when that song just says it all, because they're just discovering each other.
Tune as old as song, bittersweet and strange, finding you can change.
You think that these movies are for kids. You go at the movie and you see Beauty and the Beast and you see Belle dancing with the Beast and Angela, Mrs. Potts singing Beauty and the Beast, you cry. It doesn't matter if you're 8 years old or 78 years old, you cry. It's beautiful.
Tale as old as time, song as old as rhyme, Beauty and the Beast.
Forget your troubles, come on, get happy. You better chase all your cares away. Shout hallelujah, come on, get happy. Get ready for the judgment day.
I think what's so important about Get Happy is it was the first time that my mom was able to play a grown-up.
Come on, get happy. We're going to the promised land. We're heading across the river. Wash your sins away in the tide.
Get Happy was written by Harold Arlen and Ted Kohler in 1929. And the vocal arrangement was a great one that was done by Saul Chaplin. Chromatically, they keep changing the key. And it just builds this already great song to this fever pitch of excitement.
Get ready.
Had to be you. I wandered around and I finally found the somebody who.
I'm always, you know, very touched when you can take something that's been around a long time and then, you know, reintroduce it, especially a song like It Had to Be You.
For nobody else.
A lot of young people embraced it as if it were a new song because it really fit that film.
With all your faults, I love you still. It has to be.
I've been doing a lot of thinking. And the thing is, I love you.
What?
I love you.
How do you expect me to respond to this?
How about you love me too?
It all began tonight. I saw you and the world went away.
Tonight is an extraordinary song. What is really remarkable to me is what they did, they meaning Sondheim and Robbins and Leonard Bernstein with what is called the Tonight Quintet. It just turns that song absolutely upside down.
Lollipop, it's a sweet trip to a candy shop.
falling, I'm lying awake. I can feel myself fading away.
No.
So goodbye, please don't cry.
These are a few of my favorite things. When the dog bite.
You might have been a headache, but you never were a bore.
Oh, thank you so much.
Barely even friends.
Shout hallelujah, come on, get happy. We're gonna be going to the promised land.
Yes. It had to be you.
Oh.
It had to be you.
Oh,
I wandered around and finally found the somebody who.
For here you are. And what was just a world is a storm.
There was a training montage in Rocky, and there was no song. So I prepared about a minute and a half using, don't forget, it was a very sad movie. The guy was a loser. So to begin the training montage, I used that. And I went into the same dreary little tune, but with a beat. The director, John Avildsen, says, you know, if we could only say something. What do you mean, say something? He says, well, you know, he's jumping around at the thing. It's like he's going to fly.
Circle in a spiral, like a wheel within a wheel.
The Thomas Crown Affair produced a great song by Marilyn and Alan Bergman and Michelle Legrand called The Windmills of Your Mind.
Like the circles that you find in the windmills of your mind.
Norman Jewison, the director, wanted this song to be in counterpoint to this very wealthy playboy.
Keys that jingle in your pocket, words that jangle in your head. Why did summer go so quickly? Was it something that you said?
You could see when the McQueen character was flying this glider that he was very grim. And he wanted us to, with the song, to underline the anxiety the character was feeling at that moment.
Like the circles that you find in windmills of your mind.
Thank heaven for little girls. For little girls get bigger every day.
Thank heaven for little girls, my God. To see Chevalier just toss that off with all the charm that he possessed.
Those little eyes so helpless and appealing. One day will flash and send you crashing through the ceiling.
With that twinkle in his eye. And you knew that he'd seen a great many little girls come and go in his life, I'm sure.
Thank heaven for little.
Flashdance, Jennifer Beals. Here was this working class girl from the wrong end of town. And she had to go in for the audition.
Can I start again?
And I remember there was like judgment at Nuremberg. They're all sitting there very stiff.
When there's nothing
but and those stiff people were looking at her, and you're going, how the hell does she win them over?
no matter how cool you think you are, you will find yourself, if that song comes on in the radio in your house, going, what a feeling.
What a feeling.
Shall we dance?
1, 2, 3, and.
On a bright cloud of music, shall we fly?
1, 2, 3, and.
In The King and I, when this uptight sort of school mom English teacher comes in contact with the King of Siam, they're obviously in love, and these two, not only people, but these two worlds collide.
On the clear understanding that this kind of thing can happen.
Shall we dance? Shall we dance? Shall we dance?
Richard Rodgers was the best at getting into his characters and writing songs that were so character-driven. I mean, that is the King of Siam, and we're gonna dance, and that's the way it is.
That song was Shirley Bassey, who was a marvelous artist. She has a very strong voice, and she enunciates Goldfinger.
Goldfinger. Pretty girl, beware of this heart of gold.
Shirley Bassey killing with Goldfinger. But you know, you have to give John Barry some credit, because you know that Bond music when you first hear it.
Parents had an extensive record collection. I remember that song being on several of the recordings that we had. And I would probably have to play Summertime in my top 10 of greatest standards ever written.
I did my first recital for my church when I was 4 years old, and I sang Summertime. And it's been with me, it's been a part of my life for all of that time.
Give me my boy.
The song Fame was actually more popular than the movie.
Baby, look at me.
That song was so internationally loved that when we did a series based on the film, it went around the globe, and it was really about that music. It really, really did capture the sense of spontaneity that happens when you just are compelled to dance when you hear that kind of music.
Circles that you find in the windmills of your mind.
Thank heaven for little girls.
Thank you.
returns from Barbra Streisand, Bette Midler, and Marlon Brando when we return.
We're halfway home, so think 50. We've honored 50 songs, and there are 50 more to go. And the song at number 50 was first recorded 50 years ago, in 1954. It's one of the biggest rock and roll songs of all time, and it probably wouldn't have been if it weren't for the movies. You see, it was originally the B-side of a 45 record, but then a film called Blackboard Jungle put the song over the opening credits, and it became a number one smash. You know it? Sure you do.
1, 2, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, rock. 5, 6, 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock, rock. 9, 10, 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock, rock.
Every once in a while, there is a moment, a cinematic moment, that so perfectly captures a turning point in our culture. That was certainly the case in Blackboard Jungle and Bill Haley and the Comets' Rock Around the Clock.
Yes, Rock Around the Clock, the parents hated it. My particular parents didn't hate it, you know, and one of the reasons why I'm a musician to this day, because they encouraged me. As a matter of fact, in my back pocket is my ticket from the Bill Haley Show in Manchester in 1958 that I still have and I've still carried to this day.
Short people have long faces, and long people have short faces. Big people have little humor, and little people have no humor at all.
Donald O'Connor did Make 'Em Laugh number in One Day because he knew all those tricks so well. He was born of a family of the circus. He was very proud of it.
Make 'em laugh. Don't you know everyone wants to laugh? My dad said be an actor, my son. But be a comical one. They'll be standing in lines for those old honky-tonk monkey shines.
You will always think of Donald O'Connor when you think of that song. And how wonderful that we have those movie memories.
When I was just a little girl, I asked my mother, what will I be? Will I be pretty?
One of my all-time favorites, which was The Man Who Knew Too Much. Doris Day singing Que Sera, Sera.
Que Sera, Sera.
When they sing that song, they're about to shoot a kid upstairs.
That's my mother's voice! That's my mother singing!
What?
That is what I love that movie songs can do. The juxtaposition between what's happening. I mean, here you have this deadly scene, and only as only Hitchcock could do it. And meanwhile, you're hearing.
What lies ahead? Will we have rainbows day after day? Here's what my sweetheart said.
Zippity-Doo-Dah is from the movie Song of the South, which was a Disney fantasy. It was part animation and part live action.
Mr. Bluebird's on my shoulder. It's the truth. It's actual. Everything is satisfactual.
Satisfactual. What an incredible rhyme to make up a word. I don't think there's any real word that's satisfactual, but there is now.
Zippity-Doo-Dah, zippity-ay. Wonderful feeling, wonderful.
Don't tell me not to live, just sit and putter. Life's candy and the sun's a ball of butter. Don't bring around a cloud to rain on my parade.
The first day of shooting was in a train station in New Jersey. So it was this number, Don't Rain on My Parade.
Who told you you're allowed to rain on my parade?
It was so well conceived that it was a pleasure to perform. Even though I had a lip sync.
Whether I'm the rose of sheer perfection, a freckle on the nose of life's complexion, the cinder or the shiny apple of its eye.
Barbra Streisand was so sassy in that movie. She again
brought the music so alive through that character.
At least I didn't fake it, Hatsa. Guess I didn't make it. Get
the confidence that she had, you know, don't mess with me, was what she was saying. Don't rain on my parade. I loved it. I said, you go, girl.
In tights.
Or the bride with the guy on the side.
Or the ball where she gives him her all. That's entertainment.
The Bandwagon is my favorite movie musical of all time. It's the best songs that you could ever listen to and best performances by Sid Charisse and Fred Astaire.
A song that is winging along or a dance. With a touch of romance is the art that appeals to the heart. That's entertainment.
It was another one of those special, special numbers that just the whole world knows it by heart today.
Most people use it as an opening number, you know, in a nightclub in Vegas, wherever in the world.
The world is a stage. The stage is a world of entertainment.
Shadow to never have sunlight on your face.
The Wind Beneath My Wings said something that had never been said before, that I owe you. I owe my, you know, I owe my success to you, which is something that people want to say, and that song did it.
Did I ever tell?
People loving those two characters as much as they do, that really propelled the song to a place. I mean, it was my biggest song, my biggest seller. What a lucky person I am to have been able to sing those songs. So lucky. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank God for you. The wind beneath my wings.
Day when I'm awfully low and the world is cold, I will feel a glow just thinking of you and the way you look tonight.
I would rather hear Fred Astaire sing than anybody. He had his own style that wasn't like Frank Sinatra, wasn't like Bing Crosby, wasn't like anybody. I was just would sing like he danced.
There is nothing for me but to love you.
Fred Astaire was not known as a singer, you know, but every song he ever sang in a film remains a classic, a standard, and all the singers sing it.
Just the way you look tonight.
Luck be a lady tonight. Luck be a lady tonight. Lucky if you've ever been a lady to begin with. Luck be a lady tonight.
When I was 13, I was told about this actor named Marlon Brando, and I went to see Guys and Dolls at the Louis King's in Brooklyn.
Stick with me, baby. I'm the fella you came in with. Luck be a lady.
I mean, watching this guy who was the most gorgeous thing I've ever seen, plus singing in this very sexy voice, I was just knocked out of my seat.
So let's keep the party polite.
White only shoes,
white only shoes.
Never get out of my sight.
Come on, I'm stalling.
Stick
Come
with
on.
Me, baby, I'm the fella you came in with.
Come on, you.
Be a lady.
The guy's turning yellow.
Luck be a lady.
What are you scared of?
Luck be a lady.
What's the
matter?
Down. The rock is up and the battery down. The people riding a hole in the ground. New York, New York.
On the Town is a very interesting movie because it's a very successful adaptation of a Broadway musical, yet they threw out most of the original Broadway score. One of the songs, thankfully, that they preserved for the movie was New York, New York.
The famous places to visit are so many, so the guidebooks say. I told my grandpa I wouldn't miss on any. We got just one day, gotta see the whole town right from Yonkers on down to the bay. In just one day, New York, New York, the wonderful town. The Bronx is up and the Battery down.
The Bronx is up and the Battery is down. That pretty much sums up New York.
And when you saw the movie and you saw Sinatra and Gene Kelly, please, and Jules Munchen, and they're there, they're on location. In fact, On the Town is one of the very first movies that used a real location for a musical movie. One of the very first, if not the first. I bet you didn't know that.
New York, New York, it's a wonderful town.
1, 2, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, rock. 5, 6, 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock, rock.
Make 'em laugh, make 'em laugh, make 'em laugh.
The future's not ours to see. Que sera, sera.
Mr. Bluebird's on my shoulder.
It's the truth. It's action. Everything is satisfaction.
Don't bring around a cloud of rain on my parade.
The stage is a world of entertainment.
You ever know that you're my hero?
Just the way you
luck be a lady. Luck be a lady tonight.
It's a wonderful time.
Have you heard your favorite song yet? No doubt you will. But if you don't, do me a favor. Complain. Tell 10 friends. Send passionate emails. Corral people at the water cooler. And explain why the song you love should be on the list or ranked higher. When you do this, AFI achieves its goal to spark a national dialogue about how great movies and great songs make beautiful music together. These discussions drive millions of people back to the classics of American film. That's our ultimate goal. So let the chorus of opinion begin. It's music to our ears.
The song Fight the Power For It, Do the Right Thing actually was not intended to be the opening song. As the film progressed, Spike was like, no, this is the song, this fits the movie. I want it to be explosive, I want it to be just powerful.
Fight the power, we got to fight the powers that be. As the rhythm's designed to bounce with house, is that the rhyme designed to fill your mind now that you're real?
Fight the Power is written by Public Enemy, and there's no artist I respect more than Chuck D. The song itself is so powerful, it's a perfect fit for the movie.
Always do the right thing.
Beat the beat, we are the same, no one not the same, because we don't know the game. What we need is awareness.
As soon as that song comes on in a club or at a party, everyone starts going, you know, it just, the images of Do the Right Thing just start flashing in people's heads.
Fight the power! Fight the power! Fight the power! Fight the power! We've got to fight the power!
I'm a drunk and I don't do my job and I get fired and I can't get a job now and I... We should have done this a long time ago, taking a look at ourselves and realized we just turned into a couple of bums.
Another song, The Days of Wine and Roses, has a brilliant lyric to it. It's so poetic and beautiful. And again, that gorgeous melody by Mancini.
The days of wine and roses.
It just says exactly what the problem that they're facing is, dealing with alcoholism. Jack Lemmon was most incredible in the film.
John Shaft,
He's always rolling, always doing something. And that's when I came up with those 16 notes. Mean movement. He was cool, but he was tough. And they packed the movies to go and see this guy.
Who's the black private dick that's a sex machine to all the chicks?
Shot!
Damn right.
Who's the black private dick that's a sex machine to all the chicks? You know, you had I used like a double tonne, two words, you know, two meanings. But you know, I got away with it.
Honey Shaft was amazing. That score by Isaac Hayes was so powerful. It was very exciting to have that kind of music score a movie and be so well accepted and so celebrated.
Right on.
How would you like to swing on a star? Carry moonbeams home in a jar.
Swinging on a Star won an Oscar as the best song of the year, and people forget that Bing Crosby was not only the top box office attraction, at the same time he was the number one radio star and the number one record star.
But if you don't care a feather or a fig, you may grow up to be a pig.
How would you like to swing on a star?
Carry moonbeams home in a jar and be better off than you are. You could be swinging on a star.
Every Catholic school kid knows this one.
You can be better than you are. You could be swinging on a star.
Now, gentlemen, please. On the contrary, there's a very good word. Am I right, Bert?
Tell them what it is.
Right. It's supercalifragilisticexpialidocious, even though the sound of it is something quite atrocious.
It was such a catchy tune, and it had such a sort of rumty-tum flavor, a wonderful vaudeville flavor. I immediately identified with that because my background as a child was vaudeville.
He traveled all around the world, and everywhere he went, he'd use his word, and all would say, there goes a clever gent.
When Dukes and Martha Rogers pass a time of day with me, I say me special word, and then they ask me off to tea.
Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. I'm sure I spent a good 3 weeks trying to learn how to say that word and learning how to spell it, too.
You know, you can say it backwards, which is docious alli expiastic fragicali rufus, but that's going a bit too far, don't you think?
Indubitably.
I don't know whether it would have made any difference whether we sang it forwards or backwards.
When the cat has got your tongue, there's no need for dismay. Just summon up this word and then you've got a lot to say. But better use it carefully or it could change your life.
I like the island Manhattan.
I know you.
I never had so much fun in my life doing that number.
Life can be bright in America.
If you can fight in America.
Life is all right in America.
If you're all white in America.
It is one of the most joyous, the most humorous, the most demanding in terms of the choreography that I've ever seen in the movies.
As a Puerto Rican American, you want to start dancing, but all of a sudden, all this emotion comes out of you.
I think I go back to San Juan.
I know a boat you can get on. Bye bye.
Everyone there will give big cheers.
Everyone there will have moved here.
It's bittersweet. It's a double-edged sword, that song for me, and I think that that's the brilliance of the song.
Funny, dogs have an instinct for the right people.
Fred Astaire and Ginger Rogers always seem to play quarreling lovers. In this particular moment in Shall We Dance, they're at a roller skating rink and they're carrying on a conversation, and he says either and she says either.
You say either and I say either. You say neither and I say neither. Either, either, neither, neither. Let's call the whole thing off.
It was wonderful because they talked about you say potato and I say potato.
You like tomato and I like tomato.
potato, patata, tomato, tomato. Oh, let's call the whole thing off.
But if we call the whole thing off. Well, it was such a catchy, wonderful song. And you came out of the movie house humming it and singing it. And we've all been singing it ever since.
My first professional job as a performer was in the Broadway cast of Hair.
And love will steer the stars. This is the dawning of the age of Aquarius.
And I got to sing Aquarius every night. Also got to take off my clothes in front of 1,100 people every night, but we won't go there.
The song Aquarius, legendary. What is this time? How are we going to survive war in a time that we are blossoming with love and peace? How are we to survive?
Revelation and the mind's true liberation. Aquarius.
We were worried about that theme in the 60s, and we're worried about it now.
In America.
You like pajamas, and I like pajamas. I'll wear pajamas and give up pajamas.
When we return, a movie song inspired.
I got
rhythm.
I got
music.
I got
my gal, who could ask for anything more?
I got rhythm. That song will remain classic. I got rhythm, I got music, I got my gal.
Who could ask for anything more?
Old Man Trouble, I won't find him. You won't find him hanging round my door.
Gene Kelly was muscular and he was very sexy, and I don't know, there was this kind of a friendliness about him, a warmth that jumped off the screen when he came on the screen, and I just adored him.
I'd like to sing a song now. It was written by a friend of mine who is a great believer in major chords.
The theme from New York, New York, written by Kander and Ebb, was not the first song they had written called New York, New York. The first one was one that they played for Robert De Niro. Robert De Niro did not like the song, and begrudgingly they wrote this second number, which turned out to be one of the biggest hits of their career.
Start spreading the news, I'm leaving today. I wanna be a part of it. New York, New York.
If it weren't for De Niro, we would never, ever have written that song.
That's right.
One of the things that was that we were really pissed off. So we...
An actor telling you they didn't like the song.
So we're very, very grateful to him for that.
If I...
You don't have to be from New York to feel like that's your song. I'd be at a party in Australia, and for some reason, it closes the night.
Come through New York, New York.
Lena Horne is, as far as I'm concerned, the epitome of what every young lady should aspire to be.
Had the ability to get inside a woman's heart. It's a glorious, sad, disappointed song. Keeps raining all the time. Keeps raining all the time.
Everybody wanted to be wild then, you know, looking at that movie and those guys riding all over the place. You would hear that music and you'd see those choppers.
You got a helmet? Oh, oh, I've got a helmet.
To be wild. It's just a great rock and roll song. It's a classic expression of rebellious youth.
Born to be wild.
Saw men adjourned that evening when you find your true love.
Some Enchanted Evening is about seeing someone across a room and suddenly knowing that that is the person that you're going to spend the rest of your life with. It's one of the most eloquent lyrics ever written by Oscar Hammerstein.
Once you have found her, never let her go.
In about 65, Bobby and I were getting ready to do our fourth album. And on all of our albums, Bobby would do a single and I would do a single. And I said, what song do you want to do? I said, I want to do Unchained Melody. He says, I want to do Unchained Melody. So we flipped a coin and he won.
To the open arms of the sea, yeah.
I was in fourth, fifth grade at the time, and every single time someone would come making pottery, someone would hum the song. And I don't think we ever really understood exactly what was going on when that potter's wheel was spinning in the movie.
Whoa, my love, my darling.
Unchained Melody was one of the first songs my mother just really loved to hear me sing, and she had this dream that one day I would record this new cover version of Unchained Melody and I'd make it a big hit. And no more than a month after she first had this idea, Leanne Rimes came out with a cover of Unchained Melody and had a big hit with it, and my mom's dreams were dashed.
Coming up, a song from a great American Western and another about a cowboy from the
drama, Sundays on CBS.
With my high starch collar and my high top shoes and my hair piled high up on my head, I went to lose a jolly hour on the trolley and lost my heart instead.
Let's just discuss how beautiful
my mother looked to meet me in St. Louis.
I started to yen, so I counted to 10, then I counted to 10 again.
It's so joyful. You want to say, I want to go live in that movie.
Clang, clang, clang went the trolley. Ding, ding, ding went the bell.
Ralph Blaine came across a book that had a photo of a trolley, and the caption said, clang, clang, clang went the trolley. That's where the idea came for the song. And Hugh Martin just went to town and came up with that melody instantly.
He stayed on with me, and it was grand just to stand.
Forsake me, oh my darling, on this our wedding day. Do not forsake me, oh my darling. Wait, wait long.
The moment it comes on, when that movie starts, that melody's got you by the heartstrings. My partner David Crosby, of course, I've been making music with for the last 40 years, his father Floyd Crosby shot High Noon, and a marvelous job he did of it too.
Do not forsake me, oh my darling. Although you're grieving, I can't be leaving until I shoot Frank Miller dead.
It's a song that captures a feeling of absolute powerlessness. And so it resonates with me. It's just like, oh.
With pain, tote that barge, lift that veil. You get a little drunk and your land's in jail.
There's a million things we could go back and talk about from a civil rights standpoint. It was a different time then.
I never think politics when I think music, because it's a great piece of material, and Paul Robeson did an awesome job performing it.
No, no, not yet. Not until me and Harvey get the rules straightened out.
Rules? In a knife fight? No rules.
Well, if there ain't gonna be any rules, let's get the fight started. Someone count 1, 2, 3, go.
1, 2, 3, go.
They're characters you shouldn't like. They're criminals, they're murderers, you know. And then suddenly in the middle of the movie, you get this scene where they're just so full of charm and love, and it's all about the song. And the song has nothing to do with what you see on the screen, but it has everything to do with what's going on in your heart.
Raindrops keep falling on my head, and just like the guy whose feet are too big for his bed, nothing seems to fit.
I haven't scored that many films, but when you get a picture like that, I mean, you're kind of spoiled for life, you know?
The film Midnight Cowboy, John Schlesinger used Harry Nilsson's cover of the Fred Neil song, Everybody's Talking. It so well evoked that time and place, the ethos of New York City in 1969.
Hey! I'm walking here! I'm walking here!
I'm going where the sun keeps shining through the pouring rain. Going where the weather suits my clothes.
It's like these men are leading these horribly trapped lives.
Sailing on summer breeze.
And here comes this song that just takes me away, haunts me, and
I think it was the counterpoint to what they were living.
I'm going well, the sun keeps shining through the pouring rain. Going well, the weather suits my clothes.
Walking through a party in the county jail. The prison band was there, they began to wail. The band was jumping and the joint began to swing. You should have heard the knocked out jailbird sing. Let it rock, everybody, let it rock. Everybody in the whole cell block was dancing to the jailhouse rock.
The thing about Jailhouse Rock, which is absolutely extraordinary, and I think is that it shows the unbelievable natural depth of Elvis as a choreographer.
You can't find a partner, use a wooden chair.
Rock, rock.
Everybody, let it rock.
Rock, rock.
Everybody in the whole cell block was dancing to the jailhouse rock.
The way it was presented, you know, it didn't make Jailhouse seem so bad. You know, you were jamming to the Jailhouse Rock, and you weren't incarcerated and depressed and all that kind of stuff.
Dancing to the Jailhouse Rock, 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 rock. Dancing to the Jailhouse Rock, 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 rock. Dancing to the Jailhouse Rock, rock, rock.
There's a place for us, a time and place for us.
It's such a hopeful song. It moves me terribly. My eyes may get wet. They believe that it isn't all evil and it isn't all wicked. Somewhere, someone is going to love them.
Clang went the trolley, ding, ding, ding went the bell.
Do not forsake me, oh my darling, it just keeps rolling along.
Raindrops are falling on my head, they keep falling,
skipping over the ocean like a storm.
Everybody in the old cell block was dancing to the jailhouse rock.
Somehow, someday,
Maria!
Up next, a smash from Celine Dion as AFI's...
Someday, my prince.
When Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs came out, I remember going to see it, again, I think with my family, with my mother.
And the birds will sing.
It's just enchanting, you know. You can't help but take it home with you and keep it with you in your pocket forever.
Good is sitting alone in your room. Come hear the music play. Life is a cabaret, old chum. Come to the cabaret.
One of the strange things about the song Cabaret is that it became popular as a very sort of light, happy song. And actually, the song was written about a woman who was almost having a breakdown.
The emotional impact of that is just a wallop.
Come taste the wine, come hear the band, come blow your horn, start celebrating, right this way, your table's waiting.
Liza singing it is so potent because she's got this effervescence but this ambition, and being the daughter of Judy Garland, I mean, she had heights to climb, you know, and she climbed them, she became an icon too.
And
Now say goodnight,
please do not have
to fall. Please, it's really time for you to be in bed.
When Audrey Hepburn sings I Could Have Danced All Night. It is, I hate to admit it, but it's a song I really quite like to sing. I mean, it's, I know it's meant for a woman. I hope you don't let this out, but when she plays it, you just feel this complete and utter abandoned joy.
It's really nothing to do with having wanted to dance all evening. It's really about how it made Eliza Doolittle feel.
I only know when he began to dance with me, I could have as the morning air.
Songs in movies are normally not ever shot live. They're lip-synced, and I'm a very bad lip-syncer. So I wanted to do it live.
I was certain that our love would grow.
I wanted to design a shot that was all in one take. And as the camera just moves in a semicircle, you'll see everything you have to see.
Sing my tune.
You'll see Chris, who's also there with me, and he was feeling self-conscious. So on take two, he started to pull away, and I'm pulling him back.
Every day
I started to laugh at one point. I gave him a kiss at one point.
Spirits rise.
You can't get performances that are really real if you're lip syncing, or else there's no spontaneity in the moment.
Two lights that shine.
She wrote Evergreen, and that is I'm always surprised that she didn't write more, because it's such a beautiful song.
Ageless endeavor.
Everything that Fred Astaire sang, he entered it in a way that was totally egoless.
When we're out together dancing cheek to cheek.
Fred Astaire understood the song must be served because the song is the vehicle that gets to a person's heart.
James Cameron didn't want to have any song being sung in his movie.
Oh God!
Hold on!
But James Horner, who was writing the Titanic music, came to me and he's talking to me about the end of the movie. And I'm crying. And he says to me, go please sing the demo. I'm singing the song knowing it's a demo. And it felt incredible. Well, James Horner presented the song to James Cameron, and he said, it's Celine, I asked her to do a demo, please listen to it. He went like, tch. And he fell in love with it. And I fell in love with it too, and I fell in love with them, because I am surely so honored that I was part of a classic.
We'll see.
special people.
I'm in love with Barbara Streisand as a woman, as a director, as an actress, as a singer. She's so in charge, in a good way. She knows so much what she needs, what she wants. It scares people.
No more hunger and thirst, but first be a person who needs people.
When I first heard the song People, I said to Bob Merrill and Julie Stein, shouldn't it be people who don't need people are the luckiest people in the world? But if you can be vulnerable enough to need people, you're open to more love in your life.
A kiss on the hand may be quite continental, but diamonds are a girl's best friend.
Marilyn Monroe filled the screen in such a way that anything around her, it didn't matter.
But it won't pay the rental on your humble flat.
And you knew that if you had the chance to be with her, that you would buy her the diamonds.
Men grow cold as girls grow old, and we all lose our charms in the end. But square cut or pear shape, these rocks don't lose their shape. Diamonds are a girl's best friend.
A kiss on the hand, continental, but diamonds are a girl's best friend. A kiss may be grand, but it won't pay the rental on your humble flat.
What Diamonds Are a Girl's Best Friend embodied in a really witty, light, fun way was that this icon, this man's female fantasy, was for sale for Diamond.
Diamonds are a girl's best friend.
And indeed, there are a lot of songs that we might have considered like Love for Sale and so on and so forth, or Hey Big Spender. But there was virtually no competition in terms of the very first song that Sateen should sing to represent her character.
Cause that's those losses get back to their spouses. Diamonds are a girl's friend.
The night is bitter. The stars have lost their glitter, the winds grow colder, suddenly you're older.
Star is Born was, for me, my mother's pièce de résistance as an actor. That performance that she gave will forever be burned into my memory as the performance of her life.
Good riddance, goodbye. Every trick of his, you're on to. But fools will be fools. And where's he gone to?
I believe that Judy Garland's artistry was so fine that, I mean, when people say, oh, she brought so much of her life to her music, I don't really believe that. I believe that she didn't have to. She just was a moving human being. That was her gift.
Ever since this world began, there is nothing sadder than a one-man woman looking for the man that got away.
Someday my prince will come.
Life is a cabaret, old chum. Come to the cabaret.
cabaret.
I could have
enjoy it half as much as dancing cheek to cheek.
I've heard of affairs that are strictly platonic, but diamonds are a girl's best friend.
Man and girl, always.
Broadway musical, but the movies allow the song to soar, literally.
The sound of music, with songs they have sung for a thousand years.
That shot was filmed by me walking across a field from one end and a helicopter coming down over the trees from the other end. And we did it all over again many, many, many times. The downdraft from the jet engines as the helicopter went around me and the shot had been completed just leveled me every time. I mean, it flattened me to the ground. It was so strong. And I thought, well, I can handle this. And I braced myself and thought, you know, I don't need to fall down. And every time I would bite the dust and spit grass and sawdust and everything else. And finally, I got so mad that I shook my fist at the pilot and said, make a wider circle around, please. And all I got was, great, I got the shot, keep going, you know.
And I'll sing once more.
Oh, shut up, will you? Hey. And a shirt, wash the shirt, stupid.
Okay. All right,
well, you can't tell by the way I use my walk. I'm a woman's man, no time to talk. Music loud, women walk, but they get around. Since I was born, it's all right.
Oh, God, it gives me a chill just to think about the whole score of Staying Alive. The Bee Gees made an impact that is forever. Every generation will love that movie.
If I'm out with my friends and we hear Staying Alive, it's kind of like one of those old songs you just have to get up and dance to.
I was singing the song on tour and I was dancing a little bit and everybody was up doing that move. All our lives we will do it. It's not out of fashion, it will always remain.
Your girl is lovely, Hubble. Why don't you bring her for a drink when you come?
I can't. Something that's going to be heard and hopefully recorded by Barbara Streisand, you want it to be perfect. You start thinking of that incredible Streisand voice with the long notes.
I just started to hum and then hummed at the end. I hum a lot. I think I hum a lot of my songs. You know, sometimes we think we're going to cut it out, and then people like the humming, so it stays.
Memories light the corners of my mind. Misty watercolor memories.
job of the lyric writer in writing for the movies, the images are so strong. You have to fly at some different altitude.
It behooves the writer to try and add to them rather than repeat them.
She never fails to make it much better than we hear it in our heads.
She can reach in and like grab your soul as she's singing, you know, because her soul is in her voice.
I believe in magic in the world. That's one of the reasons that I love When You Wish Upon a Star. There is a feeling of something greater that works through all of us and helps us and guides us along. I think we all need that in our lives, and I think that's the reason that this song has sustained.
When you wish upon a star, makes no difference who you are. Anything your heart desires will come to you.
When I was a youngster, I remember going to watch Pinocchio and getting scared about the boy's nose growing, and they had to take me out of the theater crying. I was too young. I really thought mine might grow.
And sees you through.
Sunday.
Here we are. You got me into your house. You give me a drink. You put on music. Now you start opening up your personal life to me and tell me your husband won't be home for hours.
So?
Mrs. Robinson, you're trying to seduce me.
Paul said, Mike Nichols has called me. He's filming The Graduate.
Aren't you?
And he was living with the slots that he wanted the Simon and Garfunkel music to be in without having the songs written yet. I said to Mike, Paul was writing a song called Mrs. Roosevelt that he's despairing of.
Oh, God. Oh, let me out.
Don't be nervous.
And Mike said to me, I can't believe that you've written a song and you haven't told me about it. So I said, well, I haven't really decided. Should it be Mrs. Robinson or should it? Sometimes I sing Here's to You, Mrs. Roosevelt.
Here's to you, Mrs. Roosevelt.
And he said, come on, are you kidding? We're working on The Graduate. It's got to be Mrs. Robinson. That seems so apparent when Mike said it.
He said, well, we got to have that. That's perfect.
Except that I'd only written the chorus in time for the movie.
We showed him the chorus. That's all that was written. And he said, it's perfect.
And here's to you, Mrs. Robinson. Jesus loves you more than you will know. Robinson, God in heaven smiles on those who pray. Hey, 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 hey.
I'm dreaming of a white Christmas, just like the ones I used to know.
It's hard to beat White Christmas for a perfect song. That's pretty perfect.
And children listen to hear sleigh bells in the snow.
I was coming to New York, right? But the plane got diverted because of a snowstorm, and I ended up in Detroit in a Holiday Inn on my own on Christmas Eve with it snowing like hell. I turn on the TV, and there's White Christmas. There's Holiday Inn, the movie. I'm in a Holiday Inn. I'm depressed as hell. I'm supposed to be in New York with my friends having a great time, and here I am on my own in Detroit. And I'll never forget it.
I'm dreaming of a white.
Irving Berlin wrote music and lyrics. To be able to write a song that you need for a scene, and then it turns out to be something that becomes worldwide is phenomenal.
And may all your Christmases be
Mancini was a terrific musician, a great melody writer. I've recorded a lot of his songs. He asked me to sing Moon River. It's so glorious, and I love it so much, and I love the orchestration that I never get tired of singing it. I don't think Henry really got into lyrics. He was always a melody writer. And as long as you have somebody like Johnny Mercer around, who is the greatest weaver of words, I think, maybe of all.
Moon River, wider than a mile, I'm crossing you in style someday. Old dream maker.
Audrey Hepburn
sits in that window with her little kooky self, with that little guitar, you know? And she starts this wistful song about Moon River. This song was so indicative of her dreaming.
To drifters off to see the world, there's such a lot of world to see.
She sang the song herself, which was a stroke of genius, because this beautiful, melodic, untrained voice is one of the things that made the song so perfectly evocative in the movie.
Waiting round the bend, my huckleberry friend, Moon River. Desires will come to you. May your days be merry and
coming up.
Northern.
This California dew is just a little heavier than usual tonight.
Really? From where I stand, the sun is shining all over the place.
I was very lucky to be in Singing in the Rain. I was only 17 when it started, and I was just hiding behind the cameras. I was there on the set the whole time because I loved it. I thought the number was so wonderful.
I'm singing in the rain, just singing in the rain. What a glorious feeling, I'm happy again. I'm laughing at clouds so dark up above. The sun's in my heart and I'm ready for love.
It's something that you never get tired of watching. I've seen it umpteen times and I always smile.
Come on with the rain, I've a smile on my face.
Well, you know, when you grow up in the swamp, you do an awful lot of singing in the rain. So it was one of the great moments of my life when I actually got to sing that song with Gene Kelly on The Muppet Show. Pretty neat guy.
No man ever looked better so wet than Gene Kelly. Oh my gosh. And as a dancer, all I kept thinking was, he's gonna fall. He's gonna flip. And he never did. Oh, genius, genius, genius. Play as time goes by.
Oh, I can't remember it myself. I'm a little rusty on it.
I'll hum it for you. Sing it, Sam.
You must remember this. A kiss is just a kiss. A sigh is just a sigh. The fundamental things apply as time goes by.
One of my dearest friends said, Marvin, just remember that a standard has to be played in a bar on a lousy piano. He said, that's what makes this work. You're in a bar. The guy plays this, it works. And that's what a really good movie song is supposed to do.
Sam, I thought I told you never to play.
As Time Goes By was written by a man named Herman Hupfeld, not exactly a household name. Wrote the song in 1931 for a Broadway show called Everybody's Welcome. The song was a flop. When Warner Brothers was making Casablanca, they needed an old song for this particular scene in Rick's Cafe. And they found As Time Goes By, which is a song that they owned, so they didn't have to pay any money to use it, and in it went into the film.
Woman needs man, and man must have his mate that no one can deny.
Love the way they used it all through the movie. Every time they got a chance, they painted that picture with the song with just a piano and upright at that. It was so brilliant.
The world will always welcome love as time goes by.
Are you ready, Ilsa?
Toto? I have a feeling we're not in Kansas anymore.
This is part of everybody's life. Somewhere over the rainbow.
We must be over the rainbow.
I don't think anybody on this show this evening can say that they don't owe a huge debt to Judy Garland.
Judy Garland was the greatest musical performer that ever lived.
It's the perfect artist with the perfect song.
It's just heartbreaking and hopeful at the same time.
This is a little girl who does not believe that there aren't good things in this world.
And the one great joy of having children is playing that movie, and when they hear that song, every kid connects to it.
It tears me up every time I hear it.
As an adult, you even relate to it because you remember the child that you once were.
It's sort of unimaginable that, you know, a popular culture creation could be so perfect.
If happy little bluebirds fly beyond the rainbow, why can't I come on?
You can't imagine anybody else doing that role. This winsome little girl from Kansas.
Somewhere over the rainbow.
shows the ability of a song to exalt the emotions. It takes you to a place where just drama probably wouldn't. Eyes
you dare to dream really do come true. Someday I'll wish upon a star and wake up where the clouds are far behind me.
In a way, it was extremely direct and very simple, but it had so many layers beneath the surface. I think about the universality of what she is singing. By being specific, she makes it universal. And that's what an artist does.
Somewhere over the rainbow, bluebirds fly over the rainbow. Why then, oh why?
It's about longing. Everybody longs for something. More love, more happiness. And it just tugs at your heart because it's so true. It's just a piece of magic.
If happy little bluebirds fly beyond the rainbow, why, oh, why can't I?
Here we are, at the end of our musical journey, and like Dorothy from The Wizard of Oz, home again. The songs we honored tonight have echoed across the century and tell us much about who we are. Collectively, they embody the spirit of our great nation. Different voices, different drummers, but together, a grand and glorious chorus that resonates around the world. On behalf of your American Film Institute, we hope you carry these movie memories with you into the future. And with a spring in your step and a song in your heart, good night. Well, you can't-